Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I am Shubh Mehta.
And I am Akshat Shah.
And we are the co-founders of TEDxATLAS, a social and environmental initiative started by the both of us back in 2019. After working for nearly 4 years together and, you know, being on the same page on countless times, here we stand today with a conflict between us. And after several conversations and a heated debate later, we come here and this conflict is still not resolved. So I know you guys are smart and y'all can help us. So I want y'all to take sides based on what y'all think and who y'all think is right.
I strongly stand with the side that real influence influences us more.
I disagree. Real influence. Yeah. So I strongly disagree because I think real influence is what, you know, is the name of the game today.
To give you all some context, let us start from scratch. What is influence? The ability to change or impact someone is known as influence. Real influence refers to the impact that someone is making in the real world. It is based on genuine actions, achievements, credibility, consistency, and tangible impact. For instance, Changes Us has engaged 14,500 plus volunteers to divert 375 tons of waste from the coastline of Mumbai city. That's real influence for me.
Wait a minute. Who here doesn't scroll reels heedlessly in their free time? Everyone, right? And who doesn't, maybe you know, under the desk in class, guys. I see y'all smiling. So I agree that real influence is an influence that occurs when we get influenced and our thoughts, emotions, behaviors, and life decisions are influenced by people in a virtual or an online avatar, or maybe something like our online personalities or celebrities. Why do you think those 14,000 volunteers came to the beach if not for the reels and posts that we posted on social media?
Okay, let me simplify this for you all. Real influence is grounded in real life achievements, credibility, and expertise. Whereas real influence is a product of virtual storytelling and branding, which leaves an impact in the outside world, which leaves an impact outside the virtual realm. Can you all decide who wins the side? It's Shubh's argument that real influence is changing the way human species are being influenced, or whether it's my defense that real influence still upholds how human psyches are getting influenced. By a show of hands, Team Real.
Team Real? Who do y'all think? Okay, real influence. Great.
Okay, now Team Real.
Team Real? Oh, I see a lot of hands. I think
okay,
I'm going to win.
Now Team Both.
Team Both?
Okay, nice.
Okay. On second thought, I feel that real influence and real influence both are two sides of the same coin. That's social influence, right? And what is social influence for us? Social influence is the influence that we have on the people around us with both real and real influence. With the advent of social media, we can reach far, like a very huge audience, and we can send out our messages very easily. But what does it mean to be a good influencer or a true social influencer? And what does it mean to use this social influence for your own good or the good of the people around you? Let's talk about this later. But let me come to this first question. Who here watches Netflix on a regular basis? Guys, Netflix? Everyone? Cool. So Netflix, let me take you all through this fascinating show that has come up on Netflix. Have you all heard about Social Currency? Yes? Have you all watched it? No? Okay, let me take you all through what the entire, reality TV show is about. So there are 21 days and there are 8 real influencers, social media influencers, who go and stay in one villa. And their aim is to win the entire show at the end of it by collecting as many social currency tokens as possible. Now, how do we collect the social currencies, right? We collect these social currencies by performing and winning tasks which are based on online influence and offline influence, right? So now let me tell you how they did it. This show is a very good commentary on what true social influence is, right? It shows the power of influence. It also helps us understand how influencers can actually create a huge impact in the environment or the people around them. But it also showcases or highlights one small fact. The fact that if influencers are taken out of their own comfort zone, they do not, they might lose their influence. And that is shocking, right? So let me come to the next part, which, you know, tells us how the winner of the show, Mr. Akash Mehta, right? He entered the show with the least amount of online influencers, the least amount of followers. But what he did by the end of it was, he used his online influence as well as his offline influence and interpersonal influence to win tasks and ultimately the show, right? This ends our debate that true social influence happens and it is the need of the moment. And in this ever-growing digital era, what we really need is the best of both worlds. True, real influence and honest, real influence. Both, right? And moving on, to be a true social influencer, there are no prerequisites, right? So we do not need a huge social media following. Neither do we need blue verification badges, right? Guys who've bought blue verification badges, please raise your hand. Please don't buy it. Next is, for the offline realm, we do not need any past achievements. Neither do we need any kind of expertise. All we need is to start, right? Just start. And that's why, let us take you all through our three-part series, which we like to call the Change Trilogy. And there, it's a gripping three-part series that shows the journey of how we used our real influence and real influence to come together to start a youth movement in our own society.
So part one, intention. It all started on one cold November evening. It was, the year was 2018. I was feeling cold, but it wasn't because of the indistinctive humid weather or the slow brewing winds. Something else was sending chills down my spine. It was my Instagram feed, which was filled with posts related to climate change. Over the next few days, I followed more and more Instagram pages to understand the gravity of the situation. This used to give me anxiety. My anxiety level peaked when the Amazon rainforest fires happened in January 2019. That is when I thought that I need to do something about the problem that is there in front of me. At that time, I thought of using social media as a tool to raise awareness about the same. But then I realized that this is not enough and that I had to do some real live action which would create more impact. In February of 2019, that is when I came across something known as beach cleanups. I saw this as a great way of mobilizing people, making them aware of the situation, and at the same time doing my part for the towards the environment. This, after understanding these points, my intention and my determination to start something like this was very strong. Jump to June 2019. I spent the entire month going across the city to various beach cleanup sites, understanding the nuances of what goes in and out of what goes into organizing a beach cleanup. And soon after that, I pitched this idea in front of Shubh of starting something like this at our very own Girgaon Chapati beach in South Mumbai. And he agreed to it instantly. After a few permissions later, on July 21st of 2019, there we were organizing our first beach cleanup, and we had 18 volunteers. Our dreams were as big as an ocean. We were doing something big for the first time, and we felt a bit jittery. All we could do was use our social influence, our friends and families to join us. And this in turn started a domino effect, and that made all the difference.
Wow, thanks, Akshat. Now let's jump to the part two. Action, right? I'm not going to talk about Bruce Lee or Jackie Chan jumping off a building or maybe like Batman fighting Superman, a literal god. No. I'm going to take you all to my childhood. As a child, I was a very competitive person. And every time I lost or failed at something, I always got quite disappointed. In those key moments, my mom always told me that, Shubh, why don't you just control the controllables? Like, do things, control only the actions which you can control. And years later, when we faced our set of obstacles, that was a time when this piece of advice came in handy because, of course, we were facing a lot of roadblocks along the journey. So the first roadblock, of course, was the lack of volunteers. So, you know, driven by the motivation to change the world, we were very excited and we set off in style. We thought we'll try and leverage social media to reach lots of people, We'll bring, you know, like thousands of volunteers to the beach for cleanups. And we'll, you know, go all out to, you know, have some kind of a behavioral change in the society around us. But unfortunately, it wasn't as easy as it sounded. First, the lack of volunteers, what happened was that after the first few cleanups, you know, bringing a volunteers was a huge challenge. There were days when only the both of us were cleaning the beach, or only either of us. And what could have we done in this case? In this case, we thought of using word of mouth and social media marketing to help us reach more people and bring people to the beach. So what did we do? We took action, we influenced people, and it somewhat made a difference. Next, just 8 months into our journey, we realized that there was the COVID-19 lockdown, and people were scared to move out of their own houses. In this case, what could have we done? We pivoted to an online mode where we engaged our community members using online platforms and activities which kept them engaged. We did two events. We did a bunch of other activities which allowed them to be a part of this change. And this was where the behavioral change actually started. So we took action, we influenced people, and something changed. Something, right? And next, we went, you know, after the second wave, thousands of migrant laborers were stuck in the city. And all we could do was, you know, try and think about something to help them out. With no money in their pockets and no roofs over their head, of course, food was a far reach for them. In this case, we, you know, what could have we done, right? What we tried to do was, we collaborated under this initiative called Mumbai Food Run. And in Mumbai Food Run, we had a bunch of other initiatives which collaborated, and together, we distributed 40,000 plus freshly cooked meals to the people of the city. And that actually made a difference. And of course, as we, you know, across these challenges and across these obstacles that we faced in our journey, there was one thing, one weapon that helped us. And that weapon was our social influence. Our social influence allowed us to start a butterfly effect. You know, like a small butterfly flapping the wings in South America can cause a cyclone in North America, right? That's a chaos theory. And we cause this small butterfly effect to start and create a significant change in the environment around us and the society around us.
Part 3, impact. In the book, The Compound Effect, author Darren Hardy talks about something known as the snowball effect. Now, what is the snowball effect? When a snowball starts on top of the hill, it is small and insignificant. But when it goes down the hill, it collects snow and eventually becomes enormous. Unlike the rolling stone that collects no moss, social influence is like a rolling snowball. With the right intentions and right action, it grows exponentially over time, and it helps and it can make a significant impact. And this inevitably creates a circle of influence. And the advantage of creating this circle of influence is meeting like-minded people. And when these like-minded people join your team, what happens? It results in the creation of an unbreakable team. Having the right team can work wonders. They can support you in your lows, cheer you up in your highs, and correct you when you are wrong. Good teams work together, but great teams get the best out of each other. As a team, we engaged 14,500 plus volunteers who managed to overcome the urge of snoozing their Sunday morning alarms. As a team, We organize 155 weeks of beach cleanups, whether it be rain, storm, or sunny. As a team, we managed to divert 375 tons of waste from the coastline of Mumbai city. As a team, we created a 15 feet by 10 feet plastic fish installation made out of 6,000 recycled PET bottles, which helped us engage with thousands of people physically and lakhs of people digitally. As a team, we engaged five lakh plus individuals, both directly and indirectly. As a team, we motivated people to take action in their own way. Impact is measured in terms of numbers, statistics, data points, and figures. It helps us to understand our success and failures. That changes us. Over the course of 4 years, we have seen a lot of successes and failures. each success motivates us to carry on our selfless acts of service and do more. And each failure is a reminder that we need to learn from our mistakes and succeed further. But the real, it's important to evaluate in terms of metrics, because it helps us to analyze our social influence. But the real impact to us lies in the parameters that can't be metricized. That is the love and the impact that people have given us over the years, and the impact and the influence that we have had on the hearts and the minds of people.
So along the journey, we changed. We understood that to change the world, we had to change ourselves first. We had to change our actions, our habits, and our own thoughts and beliefs. So we did things that we could never dream of, and we adapted to circumstances and took consistent action to create some sort of a change in the world around us. But along the journey, we learned three vital lessons. First, that your influence is your superpower, and you have to use it to set a purposeful intention. Second, you have to wield your influence to take consistent action. And third, that keep using your social influence to create an impact around in the society. Finally, your influence. What is influence, right? No matter how many followers you have, no matter whether you have a blue tick or not, no matter how you choose to influence, maybe online or offline, and maybe, doesn't matter what influence does in the people around you. You have to keep working, right? And finally, you, with right consistent action and right intention, can create a massive impact sooner or later. So finally, I want to leave you all with this small message, which you can take home with yourselves, is that your influence is your responsibility. Your influence is your opportunity. And your influence is your power. So use it wisely. Thank you.
Thank you.
This on? Ha, thank you. So guys, just after, what we thought was that to create some sort of a change, I think we should plant the seeds of change. It's like, it's not just us talking, but doing. So we've arranged for, a small takeaway for y'all at the end of this entire event, which y'all can pick up from the exit point. There are the seeds of change. There are tomato seeds, which y'all can plant. And of course, you can sell it later. Thank you.
Thank you.